I almost forgot to tell you, we are planning to do a virtual Ganpati Darshan. हो सके तो अटेंड कर ले।
क्या? इस साल भी गणपति? I thought ये तो कैंसिल करोगे ड्यू टू कोविड। मैं नहीं आ रही। And how can you even worship that weirdly shaped god?
देख, तेरे को नहीं आना है तो मत आ। But I do object to your uninformed criticism of Ganpati Bappa.
Okay, so tell me, why would you worship a god who was made out of dirt, killed by his father, and when brought back to life was given a elephant head? Logic kya hai? Couldn't Shiva give him a human head? Like, aren't your gods with infinite power?
Whoa, hold on. I think there are certain concepts that need to be cleared. Firstly, these are all stories that aim to teach certain moral values in life. So in the case of Ganpati, the story basically aims to explain certain fundamental aspects of Sanatan Dharma, which is that the same supreme truth or God manifests in different forms. So Ma Parvati, Lord Shiva and Ganesha are nothing but the different manifestations of the same supreme truth or God. And this relationship of mother, father and son is all for the sake of the devotees. In fact, our Puranas are full of such stories that have deep symbolism and mysticism. We call such stories as Leela or play.
Pretty mindless play if you ask me. I hope this wasn't done to demonstrate world's first plastic surgery.
Nahi re. Our Leelas have much deeper spiritual significance. In fact, the concept of replacing a human head with an animal one happened with Sati's father Daksha much before Ganesh ji was born. And as far as plastic surgery goes, Sushrut Samhita has enough examples of it, which I'm more than happy to share.
Theek hai. Let's get back to Ganesha's story.
Before we begin, I just want to say that there are different versions of Ganesha's story in different Puranas. The one that I am going to tell you is the story of Ganesha as per the Shiv Puran, where Ma Parvati created this boy out of the mud of her body and then breathed life into him. She then instructed the boy to stand guard and not allow anyone inside until she finishes her bath. In the meantime, Lord Shiva returns and is stopped by this boy. Furious that he cannot enter his own house, a huge fight erupts and Lord Shiva cuts the head of the boy with his trishul. When Ma Parvati learns about this, she is grief-struck and angry to the point of threatening to destroy the universe. All the other gods try and pacify Ma Parvati, and Lord Shiva himself promises to bring the boy back to life. He instructs his Ganas to find the head of the first creature they come across. This creature happens to be an elephant. So when the head of the elephant is put back on the boy is brought back to life. He is then called Gajamukh or Gajanan because he has the head of an elephant and is also called Ganapati because he is appointed the leader of the Ganas. So this is the story of Lord Ganesha as per the Shiv Puran.
Yeah, I know this part. Like I said, a ridiculous story.
Are? Why ridiculous? Let me explain the symbolism of this story. Ma Parvati creating the boy on her own represents the mind's power to create the ego within us. It is this ego that blocks the entry of God or Guru in our heart. Lord Shiva destroying the head indicates the God destroying the ego. And the head of the elephant represents the newly gained wisdom and discrimination. Thus, individuality becomes divinized and such a person becomes a natural leader who is able to destroy all obstacles.
Hello, that seems a bit far-fetched. How on earth is Ganesha a symbol of wisdom and discrimination? Matlab kuch bhi.
Dekh, the elephant has a big head which is capable of storing a lot of information. It has big ears which shows that it's a good listener, has small eyes indicating concentration and a flexible trunk which is not only strong enough to uproot trees, but also nimble enough to handle a blade of grass. This shows a keen sense of discrimination or viveka. Perfect leadership skills, won't you agree?
Still, it all seems like an afterthought. Like you said, God can take any form. So why choose this very form and not something else?
These forms are not drawn up by some random artist's imagination. They are visualized by rishis in deep contemplation. There are specific dhyan mantras for every god, and by meditating on these dhyan mantras, one can visualize a very specific form.
Sounds like hocus pocus to me.
For an ignorant person, science can also seem like hocus pocus.
Hey, but science is logical and can be verified through experimentation.
Huh? So, you can also verify this through an experiment. All you need is the relevant apparatus that is well tuned. Your mind is the laboratory, your intellect is the scientist, the journal are the Vedic mantras. Now, do you want me to describe further?
Okay, assuming all this is true, why not come up with a better story? Why include the cruel part of beheading an innocent elephant? Why are Hindu stories always encouraging so much of violence?
Looks like you haven't read the story of Gajendra, an elephant whose life was saved by Lord Vishnu. So don't generalize things just to suit your bias.
Oh, please, don't accuse me of bias when you are so full of prejudice. And whatever justification you give, this story promotes animal cruelty.
In what way does it promote animal cruelty? Do Hindus go about cutting elephant heads to celebrate Ganesh Chaturthi? In fact, all Hindus love elephants because they see their dear Lord Ganesha in them. Our ancestors knew what lessons to learn from our stories.
Anyway, I'm still not a big fan of Ganesha.
And nobody is forcing you to become one. But that does not give you any right to insult him either. For someone who's very vocal against body shaming, you sure fixate a lot on the form of Ganesha.
That's different. But I do have the freedom to voice my opinions, don't I?
Of course, you are free to voice and discuss them. But you cannot air them publicly without a proper study of the same. If you're not inclined to study and discuss, then don't broadcast them without any consideration towards the feelings of others. To quote, "Your personal liberty to swing your arm ends where my nose begins, and Ganeshji has a very long nose."
Okay, accepted. But that doesn't mean I don't have any other objections about Ganesha.
Sure, you're free to discuss them with me.
Game on. I'll message you when I'm free. Bye.
Cool, I'll be ready. Bye for now.